This footage is from Newsbud's Confront NBC Campaign. It was filmed on August 4th, 2016, when Sabelle Edmonds and myself, Spiro, traveled from the West Coast to New York City to NBC World News headquarters to demand that NBC publicly retract their false report that was published on July 15th, 2016, when they cited a senior U.S. military source who stated that Turkish President Erdogan refused landing rights in Istanbul and is reportedly seeking asylum in Germany. This was mid-coup. Newsbud had contacted NBC via phone and email. The Turkish embassy out of Washington, D.C. also contacted NBC and officially demanded a public response and apology from NBC News. This is the footage from the day that Newsbud showed up at NBC's doorstep and demanded answers.
Because NBC News is no longer a news organization, it's an extension of CIA, Central Intelligence Agency, and Pentagon. This is what they proved here. They actively and directly participated in a coup. All they had to do, if it was just an innocent mistake, all they had to do was to issue a statement and say, NBC News apologizes for issuing a false information that they got from their senior Pentagon official, and they needed to explain and apologize. That goes within the lines of ethical journalism. For 2 weeks, despite receiving mail, letters from not only us but from other journalists, they have received official letters from another nation, and they are refusing to do that. And what does that say? That says NBC News Corporation is no longer categorized under news agencies. They are the extension of the CIA and Pentagon, and they actively participate in illegal coups and operations against sovereign nations. Okay? That's the importance of this, and this is why you are not seeing any, you're in front of NBC and you're not seeing any NBC cameras here. You are seeing members of the international press here. You are seeing alternative media and bloggers, but you don't see NBC's own cameraman here. And we are standing right in front of NBC News. I'll have other statements after we go inside and call NBC officials. Today we are going to ask their chairman, who has been notified, their CEO, who has been notified, and their executive in charge of their digital news to come out and explain why they did this, why they haven't issued official retraction, and why they haven't apologized to their viewers, not only in the US or Turkey, all around the world. Thank you.
That's right. Well, there you have an update from Sabelle, right here out in front of NBC headquarters.
You know, it's amazing. We are not seeing any members of the media, mainstream or alternative, as you can see. Soros-funded alternative media would not show up here. Wuhan.org or Truehouse.org. I mean, the names are like in millions, but and a lot of them have presence here in London, but they will not show up here because this is not Soros-sanctioned. In fact, this is Soros-opposed activism. And in fact, this is one of the things that we are doing, we are showing here, because it's not only the mainstream media, but the so-called media watchdogs, they have tens of millions of dollars budget. They have hundreds of employees. And when mainstream media disseminates PSYOP info and false information, in the past 30 years, what have they done? Have they done anything like this, confronting the mainstream media? Do we know of any instances when they really have done that, going beyond talk and writing some lame articles? We contacted Fairness and Accuracy in Reporting. They refused to provide comments and they refused to tell us about their funders. Well, we looked at their funders for Fair, Carnegie's and Rockefeller's and Ford. Ford and the Soros and Hyde Foundation. In fact, Bayer's founder and director was recently hired by NBC News with six-figure salary to work part-time. Jeff Cohen of the media watchdog, the so-called media watchdog, was hired by these bastards as a part-time employee with six figures. That should tell people we do not have anything as that can be considered media watchdog. So people should not get this false sense of security that they are a media watchdog organization. Let's donate to them and they will do this for us. No, people must show up as what we are doing here. And shame on people who were around and they didn't show up. Shame on every single pseudo-alternative media with millions of dollars that didn't show up. So today, Newsbud is doing what it said it was going to do. Not only confront NBC News, which represents all the mainstream media in the U.S., but also the absence of true media watchdog organization in the United States today. Let's expose both at the same time. And this is called actually investigative expose journalism. And if people want to consider it activism, of course, by default, it would be activism.
Nice to meet you.
I am so thankful. This gentleman here?
Hello.
He heard two corporate reports.
Actually, let me give
you
some of my drugs.
Oh.
Blue pill.
There is a blue pill, and this is a red pill. And all those people who hide in their beds and they don't join us, Newsbud, and very few handful of alternatives today available, they have either taken this one or taken that one. And you know what? Change or any kind of meaningful change is never going to come through those people, through that kind of majority. It's going to happen through the hands. And I'm very glad that you're down there.
Do you want to keep that?
I'm going to keep that.
I'll put Newsbud on that. So it just drives people to certain websites.
Okay.
And Newsbud's got to pick something people should be going out with. And I think it's great right here. The idea is that this is
it is, because in this particular case, NBC News actively, directly participated in a failed coup attempt on a sovereign nation, okay? So this is an expose, and this is the first time we are exposing them as such openly. Of course, they have been doing it in the background for years, but this is the first time a media organization is engaged actively and openly. Act of war against the nation, and I don't care what nation it is. Just doing that is against everything journalism should be, okay? And it's time to show them for who they are and what they are about. And that's exactly what we are here. This is why we travel. We are here to show that. You know what? Other alternative media, they're not showing up. It's irrelevant. They have been irrelevant. Look, how many of them have been around for decades? They haven't done anything. If you're not seeing any real confrontation, it's what Corbett has been referring to as control opposition. Give false sense of security. Say there is an organization called FAIR, and then get Rockefeller, Carnegie, the same establishment that runs these, run the same media watchdog organization. So don't wait for the ACLU, don't wait for FAIR.org, don't wait for the, who are the other, I don't even know their name, Politico.
You know, and FAIR is actually, they do great work, 90% of their work is for the things that NBC does cover, but it's always presented in a way, structured in a way, that hides the core reality of what's actually
happening. And then, and it also perpetuates learned helplessness. It says, this is how it is, now we expose it, all we have to do is kind of say, we are disgusted and move on. Well, you're saying, no, we're going to come, and we're going to come all the way, and we're going to have you explain. Explain what you did. And if you think you have no cause to issue official retraction, that means NBC News has actively, directly participated in a war, waging an illegal war against the sovereign nation. Very simple. I'm going to ask all members of media, all supporters, walk with us to NBC. We have an appointment with the chairman and the CEO to issue comment, official statement before our cameras. NBC has refused to do it on their own, with their own cameras. We notified them. We are going to go and seek their comments as journalists in front of our cameras right now. Please take out your iPhones and your cameras, journalists, bloggers. We're going to go and we're going to see the executives in NBC, and we're going to very politely and respectfully, even though they do not deserve any respect, say, we have an appointment. Here are the cameras. Explain yourself. And let's see how they treat journalists when we go inside the building, right there.
Okay, here we are. We're heading into...
Hold on.
Okay, sounds like we're getting a police.
Yeah, in the lobby. We have an appointment with three executives, NBC.
Yeah, that we're here, we're requesting them to come down.
We plan to bring this whole group inside the lobby to tell them they have an appointment with someone.
No, we've got to stay outside.
We have an appointment as journalists. We have press passes.
Who has the appointment?
We'll have
Newsbud, and it was an appointment made for the members of media. So at least the members of media
is going. Appointment to come out.
Okay, and the Anadolu agency has the appointment with me. And
many of us can go. Thank you.
Everyone, go back in the pack.
Yeah, we need
this is used by.
We need you inside the metal bag.
Do you have the appointment?
Ma'am, this is a sidewalk here. We need to keep this open for pedestrians. If we can go back in the metal bag, and we're going to get a representative to come out and talk to you.
Okay, we'll do it now. Early up moments is true.
Yes.
Then because it's.
We can meet you here. We can meet you here. Anadolu Ajansı
Başkanı.
Selçuk Bey, Anadolu Ajansı Başkanı var.
TRT World'a.
Into the free speech zone. God bless America.
Yeah. Guys, step in, please. Step in.
I gave you the area. This is all for you. Yeah. Everybody off the sidewalk.
Okay. Now the police is going to ask NBC to send their representative outside here to issue a statement and answer our questions.
If they come.
Well, if they don't come, we're gonna go.
Yeah.
She's serious.
Thank you for coming.
Absolutely. David Swanson publishes my work.
Breaking news. Members of Turkey's parliament are coming to our event right now. They are on their way. When are they arriving? Members of parliament from Turkey is joining this activism. I have to say I'm proud of this nation. I have to say I'm so very proud. And I have said several times during my interviews with COVID, we ain't gonna go down like Libya or Egypt. It's not gonna happen.
Another breaking news, we also have the Council General of the Republic of Turkey has also just confirmed that he's walking over with Turkish parliamentary members that we solicited last night. They're in town, they just happened to be in town, and they accepted our offer to join us. So
We need to give the name of the chairman and the CEO and the executive that we have appointment with.
Yes, Andrew
so
Lack.
The police can bring them downstairs, escort them downstairs.
Oh, they're not going to come down there. All I want to know is
they
their
have to send
answer.
At least
right.
Their spokesperson down
right.
there.
I want to hear their response.
Absolutely.
The police,
we are here, we are
right,
not going anywhere.
Them.
And we have members of parliament showing up here.
Right.
And they had 2 weeks, over 2 weeks. Newsbud has been seeking comments and answer. Now we came to them and we are going to get it from them. We are not leaving until we get the response.
We just got an update from the NYPD that they solicited and they informed them that we're here and we're requesting a representative to come down based on our appointment that we requested. So we're waiting for that, correct?
Okay.
Sometime this century.
Hopefully. We're not even hopefully. Sure of that.
I would like to leave and see.
Thank you.
This lady here has been a symbol of activism for more than 50 years. So she's
thank you for coming.
Famous in the community.
Yes, she's a staunch supporter of all values pertaining to Turkey. And she's everywhere. At this age, she doesn't stop. 24/7, she's everywhere.
God bless her.
She's also known as Şevkiye Teyze of our community.
That's excellent. Thank you so much for coming.
The members of police here, taxpayers right now, New York taxpayers, are paying for these guys being under the heat sun, wait here and keeping things good and I'm paying for them. It will take only 5 minutes. 5 minutes, three questions. We're not going to bombard them with 100 questions. We're not going to get out of the quarantine area like rabid people who have been put in quarantine. They can stand there. We'll ask three questions. It will take less than 5 minutes.
You said you've already talked to
absolutely. And we have the receipt for Federal Express for all our emails that were received. We have phone conversations that have been recorded by the press office for NBC, and it was recorded by Newsbud. It's three questions, less than 5 minutes, and we're gonna go. You're gonna go. They're gonna go. It's hot. It's humid, and we don't want to spend New York City's taxpayer money by holding these hardworking guys here. Okay, we are here, and then members of parliament, Turkish parliament, will be here with their security. So they have to do the right thing. Come down here and answer three questions. 5 minutes will go. Thank you very much. Thank you. This has never been done. Soros bastards would never do that, okay? We just came over here, we want to ask questions, they come on camera, and they are going to answer three questions, okay? It's factual, we have the facts, they have to explain, they have to issue official retraction in front of our cameras, they have to apologize to their viewers, and they have to apologize to the government of Turkey and to the president of Turkey, because they directly participated, sabotaged a sovereign nation, and we're not going to leave until they do. It's going to take 5 minutes, three questions. They do that in camera, they go. We brought the cameras down here. We're going to ask them three questions. In less than 5 minutes, they will be done. And now they are holding up under 85 degrees temperature under the sun. All the members of the media, their colleagues, the journalists here from these different news organizations and the police department. Because what? They can't answer three questions? It's very simple.
With our Azerbaijan community.
Azerbaijan community?
Yes.
We have a member of media here from Azerbaijan. Which organization? Onun yalan olduğunu bütün kameralar var. Evet, o yanlış ve yalan bir haberdi. Ve biz bütün seyircilerimizi, Amerika olsun, Türkiye olsun, hepsinden özür diliyoruz. Ayrıca da Türk Cumhuriyeti ve Cumhurbaşkanı Erdoğan'dan özür diliyoruz. Çünkü bu çıkardıkları yalan, Cumhurbaşkanı Erdoğan demokratik olarak seçilmiş bir cumhurbaşkanı değil. Yani sevsinler sevmesinler alakası yok. Bir cumhurbaşkanı sen Türkiye'den kaçmış durumda. Şu an uçağı Almanya'nın üstünde uçuyor. Orada asylum yapmaya çalışıyor. Aynı anda Türkiye'de onun cumhurbaşkanımız uçağı İstanbul'da inmek üzere. Yani böyle bir yalanı bile bile yalanı yaydılar. Bunun özür dilemeleri gerekiyor. Bunu bile bile yayınladılar. 9000 gazete bunu yayın yaptı. 9000 gazete. Google News'a gidin. If you go to Google News, and put Erdoğan, put the words Erdoğan asylum Germany, you're gonna get thousands of results from the Guardian UK, the Telegraph UK, Washington Post, New York Times, all of them repeating a lie that was published, put forth by NBC News. And guess what? They all picked it up. A few hours later, NBC took it out, they deleted it, but they never issued retraction. So millions, billions of people around the world, they still think it's fact, because if they go and put there the keywords Erdoğan, Germany, asylum, it says that happened. Well, it never happened. It was an information that was given and they already admitted it. to NBC by Pentagon and CIA. And they put it out, they knew it was false, they deleted it, and they never issued official retraction. And we have been demanding for past 2 weeks, come out publicly, say we apologize, it was false news, and we are issuing official retraction. They are saying, no, we're not gonna do it. That means they actually directly participated in a failed illegal coup against a sovereign nation. That's not acceptable.
The parliamentary members are stuck in the meeting with New York Times, so what we're going to do is go with our official press release here and comment, congregate everybody behind us and the media here.
What up, we, man?
Good afternoon, everyone. I'd like to express my deepest appreciation to each and every one of you for coming here and standing with our NATO ally of the Republic of Turkey. My name is İbrahim Kurtuluş. As a Turkish-American community activist, as Americans, we are simply insulted and outraged when NBC News was reporting wrong, distorted information about the attempted coup in the Republic of Turkey, which was taking place on July 15, 2016. As the attempted coup in the Republic of Turkey was taking place on July 15, a report began to circulate widely that Turkey's president, Recep Tayyip Erdogan, had fled the country by air and was requesting asylum in Germany. NBC News, right behind us here, NBC News was cited as a source of this rhetoric and this report. A tweet from MSNBC segment producer, Mr. Kyle Griffin, has also been cited in many of these articles and distorted information that they were disseminating into the US news media. We are here to stand with Newsbud and with Ms. Sibel Edmonds in supporting my mother's homeland of the Republic of Turkey in demanding a public explanation and retraction from NBC on the false reporting against the freely elected government of the Republic of Turkey and its president, Recep Tayyip Erdogan. We are here to stand with Newsbud Incorporated and Ms. Sibel Edmonds in supporting my mother's homeland of the Republic of Turkey in the face of a terrorist plot that was orchestrated by Gulen Movement, or Fethullah Gulen, the head of the organization, to topple a freely elected government of the Republic of Turkey. This is a serious problem. This is extremely serious. A major US network, news network, they were siding with ones that were trying to delegitimize the Republic of Turkey. Whose side are you really on, NBC? When is NBC going to retract the false information that they circulated into the US news media? What is NBC afraid of now? Anyone could make a mistake. Retract it. Apologize to the government of the Republic of Turkey. Apologize to the people of the Republic of Turkey. Oh, are you on the side of the terrorists? Are you on the side of Al-Qaeda, ISIL? Are you on the side of the number one terrorist that is looking to topple and delegitimize the Republic of Turkey, Fethullah Gulen? Whose side are you on, NBC? Despite all the evidence to the contrary, it is incredible that NBC to this day and its representatives cannot recognize that there was a problem, misinformation, with the media coverage that what happened then and what is still going on today in the Republic of Turkey. The distortion of information continues by people like NBC News. As an American of Turkish descent, an American of community activist, we expect fair and balanced reporting and treatment on the issues that matters to my mother's homeland of the Republic of Turkey and to our community here in the United States. We are calling on all concerned people, journalists, who expect ethical journalism
and integrity from news, NBC News, right there. NBC News took part of a coup attempt against the Republic of Turkey. We say to them, shame on you.
Shame on you. Shame on you. Shame on you.
We are demanding. We are demanding. We are demanding an apology immediately and retraction of the wrong information disseminated by NBC News. It is time. It is time for NBC to decide and to hold itself accountable and account when they get the information wrong. We are demanding that NBC stop disseminating false information of one of the most important NATO allies of the world, of a country that is sitting in the epicenter of the most chaotic region of the world today, the Republic of Turkey, and issue an apology to 80 million people of the Republic of Turkey.
We want apology.
We want apology. We want apology. We want apology. We want apology.
With that, I'd like to again express my appreciation to several people, Ali Baba, who assisted me with the police department, and also Dr. Halil Mutlu for coming here and congregating and helping everyone come here today. But a special thanks to a young lady that I had a great honor to meet this morning, but I have been following because of a friend by the name of Gushan about 8-9 years ago. Because of him, I discovered this young lady, and today she flew in all the way from Oregon to stand with the Republic of Turkey, who originally, by the way, broke the news of this wrong information that a US-based news outlet started to disseminate into the US media and to the US population. With that, welcome, Sibad. Thank you so much for being here with us. We are grateful and honored to have you.
Well, I think Mr. Ibrahim here has said everything I really wanted to say here. But I want to first thank everyone, all the activists, all the journalists, the real journalists who showed up here today to take a stand for ethical journalism, and Mr. Ibrahim for his help in organizing and getting the permit with the police department to make sure we abide by the laws here in New York City. But most importantly, I want to emphasize that this assault by NBC News was not only directed to the sovereign nation of Turkey and democratically elected president, okay? It was directed at all NBC viewers in the United States and all over the world. And this has set a very dangerous, unprecedented model here that we have never seen. Some of you may be familiar with Operation Mockingbird. This, what NBC is doing here, goes beyond that. In this case, they openly, publicly, a news organization, an organization corporation that is registered as News Corporation, actively and directly participated in an illegal failed coup attempt against the sovereign nation. This has never happened before. They cite their source, someone that they actually pay. They say our source was a senior Pentagon military official. Okay? And they have already deleted the news they published. Too late. 9,000 publications all over the world, from Telegraph and Guardian UK, Washington Post to New York Times, to newspapers in France and Germany, they printed false information that was planted and circulated by NBC News. Now, Newsbud discovered this, and from day one, they started contacting NBC News, asking them to officially retract and provide explanation how and why they circulated this false information without going through the regular, normal journalistic steps. verify the information you get. They could have called their sources in Turkey. They could have called, in fact, as they were putting this false information, people were actually showing President Erdogan's flight, tracking his flight. It was nowhere, it was about to land. This was a president who stood by his country and people who defended their country. It doesn't matter if you're supporting that president or not. The Turkish people do. It's nobody else's business. Turkey is a sovereign nation. Now, for NBC News, per their CIA and Pentagon and Fethullah Gulen instruction, directly participating in this illegal failed coup attempt, this is major news that needs to be printed by every single media around the world. And we are waiting, we have been waiting for 2 weeks for their representatives, NBC News, here we are, for their spokesperson to come down here, answer our question, and issue official retraction and apology. It takes only 3 minutes. And if they don't do that today, as news organization, as journalists, I am going to appeal not only to Turkey, but other nations to ban news agency that is not news agency. NBC News is no longer a news agency. It is working in terrorist operations against sovereign nations. They are working with a terrorist, known terrorist, Fethullah Gulen,
yeah,
and Central Intelligence Agency. So in your country, start treating them as such and not as journalists or reporters. We are going to give them another 10-15 minutes. We have been here for almost 2 hours. And if they don't issue retraction and apology and explanation, I am going to issue a call for the world, for anybody who cares about their nation, about their sovereignty, to protect themselves against these kinds of terrorism, act of terrorism. There were hundreds of people lost their lives, okay, on that day during this illegal coup attempt. And NBC News, I hold you liable for them because you participated in this terrorism act, this illegal cooperation against a sovereign nation with a democratically elected president, and it's nobody's business but Turkey's business. Thank you.
Thank you.
This is a very serious threat to the Republic of Turkey. It is no one's business but the people of Turkey. It is no one's business but the Republic of Turkey's business in supporting its government, in supporting its elected government, its elected president of Recep Tayyip Erdogan. You may like him or you may dislike him, but the fact of the matter is the people of Turkey have spoken, and they have spoken out clearly in supporting a freely elected government of the Republic of Turkey.
Oh. We support Erdogan! We support Erdogan! We support Erdogan! We support Erdogan! We support Erdogan!
This is a very serious matter in international issues. This is a group that till this day, till this minute, still is working 24/7 to wipe the Republic of Turkey off the map, to delegitimize its government, but more importantly, to delegitimize its people. That's what's dangerous. And we are here today demanding that the United States government hand over Fethullah Gulen, who has caused a tremendous attack against the Republic of Turkey. This attack on Turkey was not done by its honorable Turkish military. Let's make that clear. The Turkish military was not engaged.
That's right.
The military was hijacked by terrorists that wore Turkish military uniforms. We must understand this very clearly. The Turkish people love their military. The Turkish people stand with their military. The Turkish people, from World War I till this day, have honored and continue to honor its Mehmetçiks. And we will continue to do so. We will not allow anyone to distort the honorable history of the Turkish military and its personnel and its honorable leaders of the military. So with that, we also have like some comments in Turkish by my good friend Cahit Oktay. Okay.
Dear friends, first of all, thank you so much for being and here and supporting Turkish democracy. And since my friends already made an English speech, so let me express myself in Turkish, as also Turkish media here ready for us. Arkadaşlar çok teşekkür ediyoruz. Özellikle altını çizmeye çalıştığımız şey şu. Biz Türk-Amerikan Medya ve Gazetecileri Derneği olarak bu açıklamayı yapıyoruz aynı zamanda. Bu kabul edilemez, kabul edilemez bir şeydir. Çünkü neden? Bir medya organizasyonu dünyanın öbür ucundan başka bir ülkedeki bir darbe girişimini apaçık desteklemiştir. NBC televizyonu attığı bir tweetle, bir prodüser aracılığıyla attığı bir tweetle Cumhurbaşkanımızın Marmaristan İstanbul'a giderken Almanya'ya gitmek istediğini, İstanbul'a inmek istemediğini, Almanya sığınma talebinin ise Merkel tarafından reddedildiğini belirtmiştir. Ve bunu kaynaksız göstermiştir. Gösterdiği kaynakta doğru çıkmadığı zaman bunu tekrar silmek zorunda kalmıştır. Madem bu açıklamanın arkasındaki kaynak gerçek değildir ve bu tweet silinmiştir, o zaman bir özre ihtiyaç vardır. Biz Türk-Amerikan Medya Derneği gazetecileri ve medya mensupları olarak bu özrü bizzat NBC'den talep ediyoruz. Türk milletine ve Türk hükümetine bir özür borçlardır. Yaptıkları hareket medya etiğine sığmamaktadır. Sözü çok uzatmak istemiyorum. Herkese çok teşekkür ediyorum. Bunun özellikle altını çiziyorum. Darbeler medyalar tarafından desteklenemez. Bizzat medya bir darbenin karşısında durması gereken en büyük güçtür. Bravo. Çünkü medyalar dördüncü güç olarak kabul edilmektedir dünyanın her ülkesinde. Madem demokrasi için varız, madem medyalar insanların, toplumların sesini duyurmak için var, o zaman darbenin yanında değil, darbenin karşısında durmaya davet ediyoruz herkesi. Bütün medya kuruluşlarını, NBC başta olmak üzere. Çok teşekkür ediyorum.
Each of us, as honorary ambassadors of the Republic of Turkey, each of us has a responsibility. Our responsibility is to visit our congressional leaders, visit our city councilmen, visit our state senators, United States senators, and demand from them an explanation of how distorted information and how the U.S. government is still holding on and harboring a terrorist in the Poconos. Did the United States government want any type of evidence from any other country in the world when they went from the shores of America halfway around the world to attack Osama bin Laden? Turkey's a reliable ally. Turkey has stood with the United States since the Cold War. In Korea, our boys have died on the land of Korea to fight for freedom. It is time for America to stand with Turkey now. This is a time-tested, honored relationship that needs to be continued to be nurtured. Turkey could be the beacon of light in the Middle East. Turkey is that beacon of light in the Middle East. That today, a lot of the countries live with despotism. Turkey can be the Korea that America helped nurture in Asia. Today, Turkey is that nation. But so we stand here today again demanding an apology from NBC. Again, I want to express my deepest appreciation for Newsbud for flying all the way out from Oregon, which is 6 hours by direct flight, and Ms. Sibel took several connection flights yesterday just to stand here with us in the Turkish American community. Some may say we're not here in large numbers, but we are in large numbers. Through the media, we're in large numbers. Through the media, our message is being heard. Through the media, our message will be disseminated to all the other Turkish Americans to get them out to go and visit their congressional leaders to demand an explanation, a demand, an apology. Again, I want to thank Alibaba for helping us here, Mr. Gusham for congregating everyone, Dr. Halil also for helping us, and of course our very own Chef Gia Teza, the Teza of New York. Thank you. She's always here with us. Thank you.
Mr. Ibrahim, let's check. Yeah, we give them another 10 minutes because we have been here for two years. They have really They are disrespecting the members of the press, members of diplomatic community, organizations, news organizations here. If they don't come in the next 10, 15 minutes and issue, I'm going to issue a statement, and they are going to be liable to what's going to happen after this. Okay, I'm going to issue a statement. I just got a word. NBC News, they have declined the request from the Turkish embassy and the members of the press and the various organizations, the press community and activists to come down. They are saying they are not going to issue an apology. They are not going to issue an official retraction. They're gonna stand by their story. That's the last we heard, and we've been here now for almost 2 hours. At this point, there are three things that we're gonna be pursuing from this moment on. One, I am requesting as a journalist, as a Turkish American, as a founder and editor of Newsbud, I'm requesting that the Turkish government issue a ban to all Newsbud NBC employees and reporters. They have to be expelled from Turkey. They have to be banned. I'm going to extend this to other nations, whether it's Azerbaijan, whether it is Kuwait, whether it is Japan. NBC News is working with terrorists and Central Intelligence Agency in terrorism and coup-related operations. You do not want employees of NBC in your country. Don't wait until something like this happened to you. Okay? So we are asking for NBC employees, reporters, to be expelled from Turkey, anybody affiliated with NBC News, and from the other countries that value their sovereignty. Number two, Newsbud will be working with the various media organizations, including some of the organizations present here in Turkish, and we are going to pursue legal lawsuit against NBC News. There were people who died in Turkey on that day during this illegal coup, and this is an insult, libel, knowingly disseminating false information and declining to issue official retraction by NBC News. And collectively, they are going to face a massive lawsuit. And this is the message we have been carrying out on everything we have said. This is coming. And number three, I am asking all viewers to stop watching a propaganda and PSYOP channel. Today, we did our job. This was investigative journalism. This was other journalists coming and making a statement saying, this is not journalism. This is terrorism. This is terrorism. And NBC News is liable for their employees or anything faced by their employees from today on, whether they are here or in Turkey. You see that NBC logo and the camera. Go confront them. Go confront them. If you care about ethical journalism, if you care about, and this is for anyone, everyone, anywhere in the world, okay? And any kind of liability would be on them, on NBC News. Because as far as we are concerned, this is not a news organization. This is a terrorist organization acting on behalf of known terrorists, whether it's Fethullah Gulen or his handlers within Central Intelligence Agencies. Anywhere you see an employee, a reporter, or a poser reporter of NBC, you are dealing with a terrorist operative. Report them and confront them for their own safety, for other people in other countries, for the sake of the sovereignty of your nation. This is not done. Today is just the beginning. And you know what? It's a victory. And the more victory is going to come because we have them. And we are not going to let this go. Thank you.
Şu an Türkiye'den de takip edenler var. Çok önemli.
Journalism ethical partner. Yani ethical journalism.
Şu aşamada platformda neler yapılacak? NBC aşağıya gelip sözünü dilemedi. Şu an bizlerin Türkiye olarak neler yapacak, neler yapılması gerekiyor? Sözün borçları var.
Evet. Şimdi Sibel Hanım çok güzel değildi aslında. Yani bunun bir gazetecilik olmadığını, gazetecilik etiğiyle hiçbir şekilde bağdaşmadığı. Eğer hata yaptık diyorlarsa özür kapısı açık. Bunu Türk toplumuna, Türk hükümetine yönelik bir özürle, avukatları aracılığı olabilir, kendileri yöneticileri aracılığı olabilir, bir özür beyan edebilirler. Bunun kapısı hala açık. Hala direniyorlarsa bu apaçık darbeyi destekledikleri anlamına gelir. Yani herkesin herhalde anlayacağı şey budur. Buradan çıkan sonuç budur. Dolayısıyla yine Sibel Hanım'ın dediği gibi bunun karşısında biz Türk Amerikan toplumu olarak yine medyacılar, gazeteciler olarak çok rahat dava açabiliriz. Terör organizasyonunu destekleyen bir medya organizasyonunu tanımadığımızı, etik bulmadığımızı dile getirebiliriz. Buna kapısı her zaman açıldı. Ama biz henüz çağrılarımızı bitirmedik. Özrü bekliyoruz. Özür dileyeceklerini hala umuyoruz. Umudu kestiğimiz andan itibaren de diğer hukuki kanallara, yollara başvuracağız. Teşekkür ederim.
Thank you.
I said, you know, most likely we may end up there, Spiro, and there may be only two of us. And you know what? I don't care if it's only two of us. We will shame people. We say we stood by our words and we did this. This ended up being much better, much more than we expected. And I am discussing it with the various communities here, with their attorneys. We're going to bring a massive lawsuit, libel suit against NBC News. And, well, because we don't have any regulatory organization in our nation here to hold news organizations liable. Because it used to be FEC, that doesn't exist any longer. They became entertainment, half entertainment and half propaganda arm for the Central Intelligence Agency and for the establishment. Well, at least we have shown this. We have gone on record, and you know what? These are also historical records. There may be some pseudo places out there, whether it's Alex Jones or whoever out there, and these pseudo media watchdog organizations, basically funded by the same people who are running these organizations. But we're gonna go down the history, because we're gonna be in there as people who tried, people who really tried to do, and most likely, if not definitely, there will be no losses. These are all victories. Victories for the truth and victories for independent activism. And again, Hall of Fame, Hall of Shame, Hall of Shame, you know who wasn't here. I'm thankful for RT to send their reporters and getting B-rolls and for the fact that they're going to cover this. This is Russia Today. I'm very thankful to them. And also members of the press from Turkey, from Canada, from Azerbaijan, and we have a few independent bloggers here from the USA. I'm thankful to them for standing up for ethical journalism and for the truth. I'm thankful to everyone who showed up today. Thank you, everyone.
We'll also leave a link for our Newsbud Periscope, where we streamed the whole event live for nearly 2 hours. This is the raw, unedited footage here. Newsbud would like to thank all of our supporters and everyone who helped contribute to the Confront NBC campaign. NBC's actions are more than government-sanctioned propaganda. They actively participated in an illegal operation against a sovereign nation. Our reports and exposés were covered not only nationally but internationally, bringing this to light. And it couldn't have been done without each and every one of you out there.
In the middle of the coup, NBC published that Erdogan was on his way to Germany to seek asylum. And they say this was told to them by a US military source. So what the hell is going on there? Because that went all the way around the world and was used to further the chance of the success of the coup.